Hi, I'm Jack Barnes, President and CEO of People's United Bank. I'm here in the center of Westport, a city many cultural institutions and successful artists call home. People's United Bank is proud to support the communities where we live and work. That's why we're supporting CPTV and the many Connecticut cultural treasures they will be featuring over the coming months. Look for stories each week featuring cultural treasures in your neighborhood.
They can be sophisticated and stately, red hot and flaunted, or just lazily dangle off the vine. But no matter which character or mood, roses are the runway models of the horticultural world. And here at Hartford's historic Elizabeth Park, America's very first public rose garden still knows how to put on a show.
Beauty can be found in a rose, and when you have 15,000 rose bushes all in one place, it really provides us with a place that's just so beautiful in all its totality.
Long identified with the capital city, this iconic gazebo and its 2.5-acre rose garden made its very first impression back in 1904.
This park was designed during a time in our society where not everybody owned a house with a piece of green, with a pool, and people were engaged to come here. It was used to its fullest.
Today, with its 475 rose beds and 82 arches, it remains the centerpiece of a 101-acre jewel of a park on the city's west side. The park offers natural pathways, playgrounds, and ball fields. There's even a lawn bowling club that's been competing for 100 years. It's definitely the People's Park.
We have a core of moms that come through. We have hula hooping in one corner, Tai Chi in another corner. We have people on every bench, and they're all contemplating each other and nature. It really showcases humans at their best.
And while green spaces are a present-day concern, back in 1894, industrialist Charles M. Pond offered his estate as a gift to the city, but required it become a horticultural park named for his wife, Elizabeth. Then, with the vision of Theodore Wirth, a horticulturalist and leader of the parks movement, Elizabeth Park took shape, using nature to connect neighbors.
This park lends itself for a very comfortable and safe place for families and community to come together to just do a variety of activities.
Keeping watch over that mission is the Elizabeth Park Conservancy. Founded in 1977 and then known as the Friends of Elizabeth Park, its efforts rescued the Rose Garden during lean times. Today, this tireless nonprofit works in partnership with the city to preserve, restore, and promote the gardens and everything green.
Our goal is to raise money to do whatever the park needs within our scope of services. Our volunteers are the core of how we get things done.
Each season, volunteers tend to a gorgeous perennial garden, an assortment of annuals.
Our annual gardener really picks a great selection.
The shade garden and herb garden, and the new heritage rose garden. As for those glamorous bouquets in center stage,
I don't think people realize how much work goes into that month of June, that beautiful month when everything looks wonderful, that it takes a lot of work.
The Conservancy's work reaches beyond the roses with its community-centered mission that provides free to the public activities, education programs and tours, and of course, its free weekly summer concerts in Hartford's perfect outdoor living room.
3,000 to 5,000 people show up in the park and throw their blanket down. They're actually coming back to what they did in the 20s, 30s, and 40s.
You can jog in the park.
You can bike in the park. You can even hula hoop in the park. But you can eat here too. And at the Pond House, the food that's grown here in the park comes right to your table.
The tomatoes are out of our garden and the basils are out of our garden.
The Pond House Cafe has become a community partner with the Conservancy, a popular Hartford dining spot. It keeps its eye on the green mission set out by Charles Pond.
We go out to the garden probably twice a day to pick things, and people are always stopping us and asking, you know, are we picking stuff from the garden? And it's nice to see fresh ingredients.
For over a century, Elizabeth Park has proven a natural tapestry of design and color, of people and their vitality.
To have a venue that people not only from just our city, but from all over the state and even the country come to, it's really an incredible asset to our city.
This model green space has proven an everlasting Connecticut cultural treasure.
Funding for Connecticut's cultural treasures is provided by CPTV, Connecticut Tourism, the State Historic Preservation Office, Melinda and Paul Sullivan, and People's United Bank, what know-how can do.